Hello everyone. Now in our series of 12th IP sample question paper by CBSE board, we are solving today part A, section 1, question number 1 to 21. That is MCQ, very short answer and short answer. That is one word answer or one line answer. So total 21 questions will be there of 1 marks, in which we have to solve only 15 questions. So let us see which all questions will be asked. So CBSE has issued this paper. So you can see here, this is your sample paper. Now one by one questions we will discuss. Now this pattern will be followed during board exam. So state whether true or false, a copyright is automatically granted to authors or creators of content. Now whenever we are making our own content, suppose any music or any lyrics or anything, it can be you are writing a book or anything, so automatically that copyright is given to you. So a copyright is automatically granted to authors or creators of content, so it is true. Next, in FOSS means free open source software, source code is usually hidden from the user. Now, what does open source software means? Open means it is open, that is your source code is open to you. So here the answer will be false, because it is written that source code is usually hidden from the user. No, it is not hidden. It is open for the user. All the users can go through the source code. Like example, Linux and many free softwares are there in which you can see the program, the source code. Next, fill in the blanks. The command used to give a heading to a graph is plt.title is the answer. Now all the answers you can see in the right hand side. CBSE has given the marking scheme also. Now show will show the table, plot will draw a line, that is line chart it will should make. X label will give a label to the X axis, Y label will give a label to the Y axis, title will give the heading to a graph. So here the question was the command used to give a heading to a graph. So answer will be plt.title. Now next is write the output of the following SQL command. Select round 49.88. Now here after comma nothing is there, so it will be 0 by default, means after decimal you have to remove the digits. Now we always check when round is there, if after decimal, since we have to remove it, if the next digit after decimal is 0 to 4, then we will not disturb the integer part, and if it is 5 to 9, then plus 1 will be there. So here the answer will be 50, because 0.8 means, or 0.88 means it is in the range of 0.5. We will see just the next digit after decimal. So it is 0.8. So 8 is in the range of 5 to 9. So plus 1 will be there, and 49 plus 1 is 50. So answer will be 50. Next is given a pandas series called sequences, the command which will display the first 4 rows is. Now head is used to display the 4 rows, and in bracket argument total number of rows which you want to display, that will be there. Name of the series is sequences, so answer will be A, that is print sequences dot, it is always in small letter. All the modules you have seen, all the modules are in small letter, lowercase, and argument is 4, because 4 rows you want to see, so it is head only, not heads. Now next is given the following. Now we are going through the answers also. So two series are given, S1 and S2, and you have to print the sum of the series. So answer will be print S1 plus S2. So here on right hand side you can see the answers also, print S1 plus S2. Next is, so I will do one thing, I will use a pen here so that I can show you the outputs also. Alright. Now next is, using Python matplotlib, dash can be used to count how many values fall into each interval. Now already we have done that histogram will display the total number of values for each interval. Suppose the marks between 9200 or total how many students got in a range like 9200, then 80 to 90, 70 to 80, and so on. We are using histogram. So here the answer will be histogram. That is, in histogram it will count how many values fall in each interval. Now next is to prevent unauthorized access to and or from the network, a system known as dash can be implemented by hardware and of software. So we all know that the combination of hardware and software to prevent unauthorized access to or from the network, already we have studied, firewall is the combination of hardware and software to prevent unauthorized access in internet. Next, so answer will be firewall here. Now next is in a data frame, axis equals to 1 represents the column elements. So here we all know that axis equals to 0 are the row elements and axis equals to 1 are the column elements. So answer will be column. Which of the following is not a network topology? We have already learned all the network topologies, that is star, bus, ring, mesh, tree, so many we have learned. Now bug is an error which can be removed. So bug is not a network topology. These are the computer programming errors which can be removed. Yeah. Now next is now for web pages where the information is changed frequently, for example stock prices, weather information, which out of the following options would you advise? So we all know dynamic means at runtime and static is fixed. So static web page, you cannot change the information, and dynamic web page, we are changing the information. So stock prices and all the data, weather forecast, whatever is changing continuously, we are using the dynamic page web pages. So dynamic means at runtime you can change the data or information. So here the answer will be dynamic web page. AVG function in MySQL is an example of aggregate function. This also you have done, the 5 aggregate function where max, min, count, AVG, and max, min, count, sum, and AVG. So already 5 we have done aggregate functions. So here they have asked about AVG, so you will write aggregate function. If they ask about max, min, count, all these are aggregate for. Other than these 5, if anything else they will ask you, those are your single row function. So at that time you will select whether it is a math function, date function, or text function. Next is the practice of taking someone else's work or idea and passing them off as one's own is known as plagiarism. Now this we have already done in the last previous sample question paper also, this was given. So plagiarism means you are stealing the work of others and pasting in your name that this work as if it is done by you. So that is a crime. So that is called plagiarism. The practice of taking someone else's work or ideas and passing them off as one's own. Like suppose you are just copying, pasting someone else's project work from internet and presenting in your name, that is an example of plagiarism. Next is in pandas, the function used to check for null values in a data frame is null function you have already used. So is null function we will use in pandas to display the check the null values, whether it is null or not. Return true if it is null value, and it will return false if it is not a null value. Next is I can keep you signed in. I can remember your site preferences. I can give you locally relevant content. Who am I? So we all know these days cookies in our mobile, in our whenever we are using internet. Simply whenever, suppose I want to make a cake and I am searching that how to make a cake. Now automatically you will see that all your social sites are showing you how to make the cake. So videos, many things you will get about that topic. So, and whenever you are signing in, it will ask you whether to save it or not. So I can keep you sign in. So cookies is the answer. Next is, who amongst the following is not an example of browser? So we all know Chrome is a browser, Firefox is a browser, Edge is a browser, whereas Avast is an antivirus. So we all have already used Avast. Avast is an antivirus, it is not a browser. Next, a mail or message sent to a large number of people indiscriminately without their consent is called spam. Now spam, we all know when we are using our mail, that time there are many spams without our knowledge to just to a large number of people they are sending it, and so this mail is called a spam. Next, according to the survey, one of the major Asian countries generates approximately about 2 million tons of electronic waste per year. Only 1.5% of the total e-waste gets recycled. Suggest a method to manage e-waste. Now, e-waste, you cannot throw here and there. So, e-waste only to some companies are there where you have to, either you have to submit it there. You can call them, they can collect it also. Now, here it is written by CBSE, the answer is buy environmentally friendly electronics, donate used electronics to social programs, reuse, refurbish electronics, recycling of e-waste. So normally it is done, we are giving to those companies and they are recycling it, and we are trying to reuse or give to you can give to any organization who will simply reuse your electronic items. Next is, the dash command can be used to make changes in the rows of a table. Now we all know update command is used to make changes in a row of a table. So here the answer will be update. Whenever we want to change any data, we are using update table name, set column name equals to the new value and where we use the condition. Next, write the SQL command that will display the current date and time. So we have already used now. So to display the current date and time, select now and parenthesis. So semicolon we have to use in MySQL. So now is the SQL command function that will display the current date and time. Next, dash network device is known as intelligent hub. Now hub we are using to connect all the computers, and intelligent hub means switch will be the answer, as whenever we are using switch, they know that which computer is sending the information to which computer, and directly it will send the information to that computer. So routing also it is done, routing work also it is done. So switch is intelligent hub. Next, receiving irrelevant unwanted emails repeatedly in, and this already it was asked, that unwanted or irrelevant emails, huge bulk of mails, so all these are called spam or spamming. Yeah, so this is your section one. Now go through the questions and you just see that what type of questions from MySQL, from networking, from security, society, law and ethics, and from Python, that is your data frame series as well as your pipelot. So which all questions are asked, that you go through, and if you have any doubt, you just write in the comment section whatever doubts you are having. So this was your first, that is part A, section 1, 1 to 21, MCQ, short answer and very short answers, that is one word or one line, and total 21 questions were there. Now in the next video, we will do our two case study, that is section 2 of part A, that is one case study of data frame and the second case study of MySQL. So these are very easy, you just simply go through it and you will understand how to write the answers. So we will try to make 5 videos covering each topic, each section. You can see here each section is there. So just enjoy learning. Have a nice day. Thank you.